Hello everyone, and welcome back to our inventory system series in Godot 4. In this video, we will start adding functionality to our inventory slot component, so let's go ahead and open up our inventory slot script. At the top of our script, we will create node references to our item name, item quantity, detail and usage panel, and detail label nodes. After you've done that, we'll need to create a variable that holds the data for the item that we currently want to hold in the slot. When we load this game, this value will be empty, meaning we have an empty slot. Now when we press our button, we want to show or hide our usage panel, but only if we have an item that is available within the slot. So if we press on it and there is no item, meaning the slot is empty, we shouldn't be able to use or drop the item, so we shouldn't show the menu to be able to use or drop an item that doesn't exist. Then, if we hover on our slot in our mouse entered signal function, we should show the details of the item. Hence, we should show the details panel, but just like before, we should only show the details panel if there is an item available in the slot. And then finally, if we unhover on our slot, we will hide our details panel. So when we start our game and we open up the inventory when we press I, we want the grid to be populated with empty slots. So let's begin with creating a function that will create an empty slot with no values. We'll also need to create a function that will set the slot with the details of a new item that we want to add to the inventory. This function will need to update the icon, quantity, and item details based on the new item dictionary passed to it from our inventory item component. So just to reiterate, the setEmpty function will create an empty slot, and the setItem function will create a slot with an item. Now back in our inventory UI function, we created a function called onInventoryUpdated that's supposed to populate our grid with slots, but back then we didn't have a slot. Now that we have the slot component, we can complete this function by populating our grid with empty slots. Before we do this though, we'll have to create a path reference to our inventory slot in our global script. Now back in our inventory UI script, we will iterate through each item in our global inventory array, and for each item, we will add a slot. So for each item, we will create a new slot from the inventory slot scene and add it to the grid container. Now that we've created our slots, we'll need to check if the slot position that we're trying to create contains an item, so that we can populate it with the item's details. Otherwise, if it contains no item, we'll just create an empty slot. Now if you're on your scene and you open up your inventory should spawn with empty slots. But if you pick up an item, the item should be added to the inventory system. The details of the item should also show if you hover over it. Please note that when I first made this inventory system, I made it on a smaller screen, so that's why it looks so odd.
Alright, Pinhead, your time is up!
Who are you calling Pinhead?
There is one last thing that I want us to do to make some changes to our inventory UI, because as you saw, the slots are a bit too close to one another, and that is because we didn't change its H and V separation values on the grid container. So go back to your inventory UI scene and select your grid container, and underneath theme overrides, change the H and V separation to a value a bit higher. I'm going to change mine to 20 on each. Now, if you're on your scene, your inventory should be spaced appropriately, and if you run over items and add it to the inventory, it should be added each in their individual slots, or it should be stacked depending on the type and effect of the item. And if you hover over it, it should show its individual values. We'll break off this part here, and in the next video, we will complete our slot system by adding the functionality to drop our items back into the world. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.